This is part 4 of solving equations containing radical expressions. We're just doing more examples. So in this video, we'll be solving the following 3 equations. To solve this problem, we have 2 radicals. So we want to isolate 1 radical. Now, it doesn't matter which one you isolate. I usually isolate the one that looks more complicated, which will be the square root of x plus 9. So what I'm going to do is put that on the right side of the equation, so it's positive. So I'll have a positive in front of the square root sign by adding square root of x plus 9 to both sides. And then I'll have to subtract 1 from both sides so that I have square root of x minus 1 on the left-hand side of the equation. So I've isolated the square root of x plus 9 on the right side of the equation. All right, once we isolate it, we want to square both sides so that we can undo that square root. If it was a cube root, of course, we would cube it, and fourth root, we would raise it to the fourth power. All right, so we're going to square both sides, but on the left-hand side, it's binomial. It's a binomial squared. So be careful. If you want, you could write that out as square root of x minus 1 times square root of x minus 1, and that will give you x minus 2 square roots of x plus 1. I'm not showing all these steps, but you could go out on the side and do the FOIL method, square root of x minus 1 times square root of x minus 1. And on the right side, when we square the square root, I get what's underneath the radical, which will just be the x plus 9. All right, so there's still a square root in here. So now we need to isolate that next square root. So for the moment, I'll just leave this square root, negative 2 squares of x on the left-hand side of the equation, but let's get rid of the, subtract x and subtract 1 from both sides. So we'll subtract x and subtract 1 from both sides. So I have negative 2 squares of x equals 9 minus 1 is 8. Okay, and then we could divide both sides by negative 2, so I have the square root of x all by itself on one side. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Divide both sides by the coefficient of the square root, and that will give me square root of x equals negative 4. And right there, you should note that's impossible. The square root of something is always non-negative, so there is no solution for x. So the answer to this problem is the null set, right? There's no solution, right? Because you can't have a square root equaling a negative number. And remember, you could also write the null set as braces with nothing in them. All right, here's a problem where we have a square root on one side equaling to the square root of the other side. So we could just square both sides because they're both isolated in this case, and we get what's underneath the radical, 7x minus 5 equals 5 minus 7x. All right, so now to solve this, we need to get the variables on one side, constants on the other, because it's linear, right? There's no x squared term. So let's say add 7x to both sides and add 5 to both sides. We get 14x equals 10. Divide both sides by 10. I'm sorry, divide both sides by 14. So we get x equals 5/7. And then, of course, we want to check it. So let's check it in the original. So we're going to put in 5/7 for x, so 7 times 5/7 minus 5. So on the left side, the 7's cancel underneath here, and I end up with 5 minus 5. Everybody see that? Which is 0. So you get the square root of 0, which is 0. And now let's go ahead and simplify the right-hand side by plugging in 5/7 for x. So I get 5 minus, again the 7's cancel, I have 5 minus 5, which is square root of 0, also a 0. So there we are, 5/7 is the correct answer. All right, here's a problem with the fourth root. Again, we want to begin by isolating the radical, which is the fourth root. So we want to add 5 to both sides. So we've got the fourth root of x plus 3 is equal to 2. Now, when you're dealing with the fourth root, remember the fourth root can't equal a negative number, but this has it equaling a positive number, so we're okay here. If it would have been equal to negative 3 or negative 2, you could have stopped right then, and that would be an impossible situation, and there'd be no solution. But in this case, since a fourth root is equal to a non-negative number, you can go ahead and raise each side to the fourth power. So we get x plus 3 on the left-hand side, and 2 to the fourth is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is 16. And then we simply subtract 3 from both sides. Get x equals 13. All right, now we want to check it. So we want to put the original problem, fourth root of x plus 3 minus 5 equals negative 3, and we're going to plug in 13 for x. All right, so that gives us the fourth root of, I'm running out of space here. Because it's the fourth root of 16 minus 5. Fourth root of 16, you have to think, well, what number to the fourth is 16? That's 2. So this becomes 2 minus 5. And 2 minus 5 is negative 3. All right, so the left side simplifies to negative 3, and the right side is also simplified to negative 3. So it checks. So for this problem, x equals 13 is our answer. And so there's our solution. Checked and all.